Hi, and welcome to the Product Design Show. I'm Allison Topperwine.
And I'm Vince Penman. In this episode, we'll take a look at how some of the bottles we use every day are designed for different functions, and we'll also explore some new designs for bottles.
Just in case you're not familiar, a bottle is basically just a sealable container that holds some sort of fluid or other material that needs a little extra help sticking together. We come across bottles in a huge variety of shapes and sizes. Most of us never stop to think of the engineering and design that goes into them. For example, take your average soda bottle. It looks simple enough, right? But consider the fact that soda pop contains carbon dioxide gas in solution. If we shake the bottle or heat it, that gas can come out of the solution and create a huge amount of pressure. The bottle has to be designed to withstand that pressure. So the soda bottle is actually an example of a pressure vessel, a closed container specifically designed to hold liquid or gases at pressures higher than the outside ambient pressure.
Have you ever wondered why you never see a square soda bottle? That's because pressure forces inside a bottle are always normal, meaning they push perpendicular to the surfaces. Because of this normal force, a pressure vessel will tend to want to balloon outward. A square-shaped bottle would have stress from the pressure pushing out that would be concentrated at the corners, turning them into weak spots where the bottle would want to tear apart. That's why most pressure vessels, including soda bottles, are round. In fact, the ideal shape for a pressure vessel would be a perfect sphere. Unfortunately, spherical bottles are hard to manufacture. Plus, they'd be really hard to stock on a shelf, wouldn't they?
Sometimes we want a bottle to hold a fluid at a different temperature than its surroundings. Thermos has been designing bottles to keep fluids at different temperatures for over 100 years. They're so good at it that we call most insulated bottles thermoses. Kind of like we call tissue Kleenex, cotton swabs on a stick Q-tips, and crappy action movies another Michael Bay crap-taster piece. But how does a thermos manage to keep hot fluids hot and cold ones cold? Heat transfers from one object to another in three ways: conduction, convection, and radiation. Thermoses are designed to minimize the effects of these three forms of heat transfer.
The basic design for a thermos is a jar within another jar. But don't worry, we'll set up a kick to make sure that nothing gets stuck inside the jar within a jar and ends up in limbo. Ah, I digress. A layer of poorly conducting or insulating material sits between the two jars to prevent heat loss through conduction. The space between the two jars is also airtight, so heat can't escape through air convection. And in some thermoses, the interior surface also has a shiny mirror-like finish that will reflect any heat radiation back into the liquid inside.
Now, not every bottle has to hold liquid under pressure or keep it at a high or low temperature. Sometimes all a bottle has to do is look good. A funky bottle design can go a long way in helping a product stand out from its competitors. Many bottle designers use CAD tools to create fancy, eye-catching bottles and to take a virtual look at them in 3D. Salt in Europe, the owners of the Russell Hobbs brand, use Creo Parametric to design their stylish kettles and apply surface rendering to create photorealistic images that are ready for the pages of the sales brochure.
You can see Creo Parametric, the same software that engineers use at Salt in Europe, for yourself. Just go to ptc.com/go/Creo Parametric. That's it for the Product Design Show this week. If you like the show, please give it a like on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, or give us a rating on iTunes. We'll see you next week when we look at the engineering behind heating and air conditioning. Ooh.